Hello, Dr. Pi. When do you think you can do 150 change work plans by to upgrade 150 routers?
150? That's going to take ages. Several days. 3 days.
Okay. It would be better if you could do it before then. Could you see if you can do it before then?
3 days? No, not sure.
Okay. Yes. If you can update me as soon as possible, and then I'll tell my manager. Thank you.
Okay. Right. Okay, so step one from the command prompt, pip install docxtpl. And we'll get a few warning messages. It's Jinja's already installed, running setup install for Python docx. And it's telling me to upgrade pip, which is not a problem. That's the usual message. So far, so good. Okay, so I didn't want to make this too complicated to start with. So just to begin with, we're going to write a work plan. And what we do is we write a Word document. So just a standard docx Word document. And then we write, basically we write how we want the final generated Word document to appear. But the variables, the things which change in each document, the things which are unique to each document number, and then we just save that. And we're going to save that as workplan underscore template. So that's that. That's the template done. Okay, next, let's start writing some Python code. So what we'll do is we go to docxtpl.readthedocs.io, which is Python docx template official documentation, and the usage. So what we'll do is we'll copy this text from here. So it's text at the moment. It's not Python code yet. And then if you've got an editor, you can use whatever editor you want, VS Code, IDLE. I've just used IDLE here. And what I've done is just pasted in the default code, and let's begin changing their code. So they're saying doc equals docx template. So docx template is the module. And let's just change that. So we need to change the template name. So I've saved the template with capital at the start of each. So we'll say, what did I call it? Word template, I think I called it. Let me just check that. In fact, it doesn't matter. We'll run it anyway. So if we remember what I've used on the work plan, so the first thing I used was work plan. So the first thing in the double curly braces was work plan underscore number. And I'm just going to code that in here. We'll dynamically read that in due course. So work plan number 101. Next was person. So we will call person. So what I'm typing here before the colon must match what we've got in the Word template. And let's just call that Bob, which it's usually Bob, isn't it? Or Boo or Bar. And next we want location. So double quotes. Don't think it makes any difference, but just for readability, we'll use double quotes. And then location. Should be a comma, sorry. And then location, we will say London. Doc.render context. So that's just going to render everything that we've just put into the context. It's going to substitute all of these. So 101, Bob, and London. So in our output file, we should have a work plan 101. The person will be called Bob, and London will be the location. And then we do doc.save generated doc. Oh, so this is the name of the file. So we will call this YouTube workplan. And then, however you run it, so VS Code, idle, whatever. So from here to run it in idle, we'll just do this. And we've got an error. Why is that? Package not found, word underscore template docx. Right, that's fine. Let's investigate what that is all about. So word underscore template docx. Ah, have I saved this in the correct location? Yes, I have. Test one. Right. Let's investigate. And if some of you might have been a bit ahead of me on this, it should have been called workplan underscore template. So, yeah. Just remember, this must match what you've called your workplan template. If you call it ABC underscore template, then obviously that's what you put in here. Let's run it again. F5. And this time we have no error. So if we go across to the, just going to open up the file and hopefully it'll open up on the right screen. There we go. Workplan 101. Oh, not registered. Naughty, naughty. Workplan 101. Who is doing it, Bob? Site location, London. So that is a new file based upon the template. Next, we'll do this dynamically and we'll read some values from a CSV. Okay, just to make this a little bit more believable, what we're going to do is we will we'll put in some dummy data. So what I'm going to do is just have and I've just remembered I need to have a work plan number as well. So if we do insert work plan number 149, I'm happy with that. Right, good. So save that and off we go. Let's write some more code. Okay, so let's modify this to read from the CSV. So with open, and then we pass it the name of our CSV, which is wpinfo.csv. We just open it for read, so that's all right, as CSV file. You can call that whatever you want, really, but just make it something meaningful. And then and we will just comment that as well. Yeah, that's read it. So that's read all of those into a list. So if we do print type, we should see that we have a list. And if I run that again, you see here we've got class list, which is good. So next we need to say for item in OP, and then we can begin, we can actually uncomment this again. So we will just go format, uncomment region. We need to indent this because it's inside a for loop. And then we need to start thinking about what we're doing here. So we will say the doc equals, that's good, that's fine, leave that as it is. And this is the bit we need to change. We all need to change this. So we're using F string here. I'll come back to it a bit in a minute because that's the more time consuming. So we will say, and then what we'll do is we'll just call it, we'll call it the name of the, so we've got many, many lines, 171 lines. So for, we've got 171 lines and then we need to split that line and then we need to extract the How far along was it? Let's just have a look. Just check. We need to check how where we need to check where the location was, the city. So the work plan's going to be let's call it the work plan number. So we'll copy that. And also we'll call it we'll put the location in as well. I think that should that's gonna get messy. So let's just leave it at that. We'll just call it a work plan number, so that's fine. So this is the important bit. So to get this, we need to replace these bits here. So let's just get rid of all of those. That's rubbish now. So if we can open up that, we'll see that work plan number city. So the first one's going to be rubbish. So we can we say ignore first item in list. And then the next one will be, we need to read that and we need to divide it up. And let's say we'll call it something else. So WP num equals, that will equal Okay, so ignore the first item in the list. The first item in the list is actually the CSV header, so we don't want that. So we want to just get effectively miss out index 0. So we'll go from index 1 onwards. And then what I've done is I've just said work plan number equals split the row, and then we just take the first part of that row. So the work plan number will be that. First name equals split it, and then take the index 1. So index 1 will be the first name. All I've done here is I've done an F string and printed it all to the screen just so that I can just double check it. So don't worry about this, it's a mess because it's not formatted properly. But the reason why I've done this is so that I can then pick out each of these and then use them with the render function. So what we need to do next is actually just comment that out and uncomment these lines. We do format uncomment, and then so we still have the doc is equal to the template, the context. So this is the context that we then need to go back and do like we did earlier. So we will say what I've done actually is I've kept the variable names the same as what I've extracted from the list. So that should keep things simple. So work plan number, this is what must match the, this must match what we've got in the Word document. And then work plan number here is the variable name. So I'm just gonna space this out a bit, make it nicer to read. So work plan number, and because it's in curly braces, we can format it a bit more nicely. So next we want same again. So we'll do first underscore name. Remember to do a double colon, not equals, like I nearly did there. And then we say first. So first name here is actually just matching what we've extracted from our list. City, so again city, that is the name of the placeholder in the template, and then the city here is what we've extracted from the list, and so on. So postal, it just it keeps it neater if you just keep them the same. Postal. phone to. Again, on the left is the placeholder name, and on the right is the name of the variable that we've extracted from our CSV file. Sorry about the slow typing. Right, I think that's ready to run. So, if you'd like to see some, magic, what I'm actually going to do is just drag across my folder, and what I need to do actually is, let me just make the icons smaller, and this is all a bit impromptu, but let's just drag this across, and I'm going to put this here. And when I run this, hopefully, fingers crossed, yeah, let's just keep that down there as well so we can see what's going on. And if I run it, let's go for it. F string empty expression not allowed. Oh. My little faux pas there. Sorry about that. Right. And wow, do you see this? See how many work plans? 120, wow, 130, 140, 149 work plans in about 3 seconds, 5 seconds maybe. Wow. So, that's a lot of work plans, everybody. Would you agree? I think that's pretty impressive. Let's just pick one at random, 62. And Surrey. Oh. We appear to have a couple of anomalies. That's partly, I think that's due to me not getting my variable names in the correct order. So email, we seem to be all out of sync. Let's go and fix that. Okay, so if you were looking closely, you would have spotted that I'd actually got, I'd missed out county. So not 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So if I put in county, work plan number, first name, city, county, postal, phone to, email. That looks better. So let's run it again and let's see what happens. So if you're ready, 5 seconds. And quickly, there we go. We're making up to 100, 120, 140, 149 work plans. So hold your breath and let's check it. Okay, so you probably will have observed that I neglected to put county actually into the context. So very important, all the variables that you want to appear in the template, you must put obviously into the context. Right, let's run it again, and third time lucky. So let's just let you see them being created, and already we're up to 84, 80, 111, and 149. Wow, that was quick. So yes, with success. excuse the license thing. There we go. So we've got 149 work plans, and I think obviously I've only used a certain number of variables here, but you could equally add in many, many more variables. And as long as the information's in your text file, then it'll end up in your work plan. And yeah, these are only the things which change each time. So if you had a big block of text that's always in there and it never changes, then just put it into your template and happy days, because it will just stay the same and you don't even need to modify any of the things with the curly braces or with your code. So if you found this interesting or useful, please give it a thumbs up, give me a subscribe, watch the whole video. Don't just, you know, anyway, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you. Thanks for watching.